Hey guys, per usual, everything on this channel is for educational purposes only and is not intended as financial advice. So, full disclosure, I own none of these coins. I've only ever traded LTC. I think most alts are complete trash. Let's get into some charts. So, daily ETC, BTC, depending on the coin, depending on how much data there is for the coin, I went through a few charts for each of these. Towards the end, there's less because there's fewer data on those coins. Just FYI, everything will be in the chart description, video description. If it's above the character limit, I'll have to put it on a Google Doc, and there'll be a link in the description so you can click around for that. So ETH, BTC, doubled cloud. I was watching this Adam Eve over, let's see, since January, December even, play out. So the target's still up here. It kind of got there, you know, it's between the yearly pivot, something which I've never actually seen anybody put on an altcoin chart. Not that I watch a lot of altcoin charts, but yearly pivots on some of these charts are playing out quite nicely. And as you can see here, boom, yearly pivot resistance. So back to the cloud. As like I always say, any flat line on the cloud is a target. And you can see it hit this target, it hit this target. It almost hit the Adam and Eve target. As far as the entry signals are concerned, we are doing really well for the 2x cloud. So this is definitely says entry here is fine. You know, between now and a week from now, everything looks fine. It's probably best to just wait for a break of the yearly pivot, which would be the previous local. This basically looks like a bull flag that's breaking up right now. That's something to watch over the next week. And if we go to singled, we can see how much earlier we got in, but we also got out on the TK cross and re-entered on the recross. So depending on the coin, depending on how you want to play it, doubled or singled cloud is best. If you just want to keep it simple, stupid, do singled cloud on daily charts only and just watch that. And if it doesn't have enough data for a daily chart, just don't trade it because it might not be worth it. If you want to trade it anyway, trade it on the 4-hour using singled cloud. So what I'm saying here is everything is bullish, obviously. If it was bullish on the doubled, it's going to be bullish on the singled. And also I'm saying wait for the TK cross. This isn't exactly a clean cross. Wait for the Kijun bounce, which would be a touch of this zone and then a bounce up or a break of the yearly pivot. And like I said already, it looks like a bull flag trying to break up. You know, it still hasn't fulfilled this 0.017 level as far as the target for the Adam and Eve. So it's got at least that in it. And the R1 is up here. So, you know, I like anywhere between 0.017 and 50% of the distance between these pivots, whatever that is, 0.022 maybe, as far as the next move is concerned. Doubled 4-hour, and you'll notice between on the 4-hour, doubled and single cloud kind of look the same for a lot of these. So here I'm saying nothing because I didn't put it on here, but look for a Kijun bounce, and you can see it's kind of got held up by the Tenkan. So when you start to see that, and yes, it's curve fitting, but when you start to see that, you can just go to the singled and you can say, oh, wow, if I'm looking specifically for the Kijun bounce, that's what it's going to look like. Those are my re-entries, okay? And again, this is a flag trying to break up. Whether or not it'll break this local and previous local and yearly pivot, who knows? But it certainly looks bullish continuation to me. It does not look anything like this, which is sort of just sideways. And then a re-break of the cloud, etc. So again, this is the entry you're looking for in the future. Break of the cloud, bullish TK, price above cloud, bullish cloud, lagging span above, price above cloud. Yes, it's retrospective, but that's what you want to look for, okay? I also did EMAs for a few of these, so here's the daily 5200. We still haven't gotten the golden cross. Death cross was quite prophetic, played out nicely. You got a nice trade off of that. And anytime you play the crosses, you can just use a backtested strategy, which is what I'm about to say is, you know, when we get a cross, hold it until you cross the 50. That's all you have to do. So for this one, go long when you see the cross, hold it until you see a cross of the 50. Or put your stop at the 50, whatever you want to do. Or you can hold it until you get a recross of the EMAs, which would be a longer time frames capturing strategy. On the 4-hour, the EMAs looked great as far as entries are concerned. It got a little noisy in here because it just moved faster than EMAs did. But, you know, again, once it broke the 50 and 200, there's your entry. There's another way to play EMAs. So your stop on the 4 hour could be a stop at the 200 and re-entry. So if the 50 is over 200, you know it's bullish, and the re-entry would be the break of the 50. If it's 50 below the 200, you know your re-entry is a break of the 50, either way. So again, that's another way to play EMAs. So it's ETH BTC. Now looking at ETH BTC, I didn't realize that Ethereum hit 20 bucks again, which is nuts. It's basically pre-DAO hack levels. This was the DAO hack here. You can't see it, but this was a cup and handle with the measured move to about 22. And it almost made it before the DAO hack. And again, yearly pivots. I also added a fib extension on here. So anywhere between 29 and 31 and a half or something, I think is a great target for this next move. Again, bull flag looking like it's breaking up. This looks super overbought on the daily doubled cloud. You can see how far away we are from the TK lines. Is all this space to explore should price decide to fall back down, you know, similar to here. It doesn't look like an entry right now as we stand, but I think if we break new highs, break previous highs, previous local, we're going to shoot through all-time high and look for 29 and 30 levels, definitely. Cloud's all bullish, that's no surprise. On the single just gets you in as far as entry signals are concerned earlier. On ETH USD anyway, it's not noisy, but on some of these coins it is. So, you know, your entry would be here, and you're still holding based on the cloud signals. You're just holding. I don't know what the fractal stop would be, but it'd probably be this zone now. After a few candles, it would draw it. But again, TK C-clamp, we're overbought for sure, definitely. Super bullish, almost bubble-like conditions, dare I say it, on lower time frames especially. 4 hour doubled. You can see you had the Kijun bounce a couple times. It's not always perfect, but it's usually around about either above or below the Kijun, which is just the 50% line. And I'm saying this flag is breaking up because you can see the triangle here and the point of the triangle trying to break this yearly pivot. The retrace targets would be the Kijun again and the flat Kumo of the cloud. Should this fail to break the pivot or local high, expect it to go back to 15 and a half. If it does break the local high and pivot and make a bear div, expect that to pull back to about 50% as well. So that's, you know, just look for weakness. I don't have the RSI on here, but look for weakness if it does break this previous local as far as entry is concerned, on lower time frames especially. And then single looks about the same, so there's not much more to say about that. So for ETH USD, singled cloud on daily and 4 hour is probably best. Daily Golden Cross happened February. I mentioned it in the article I got posted on Crypto Hustle. So that was definitely an entry sign for the longs. Your target could have been the yearly pivot. I didn't talk about that in the article, but because I didn't think about pivots with altcoins very much. And then again, the FIB extension and the yearly pivot has a somewhere between 29 and 31. So there's your long entry. There's your target. Your stop could be 50% of whatever the move is here. That you could find that on the cloud. Your stop could be like 15. Your target could be 30. That's a pretty good R&R. Here is 4 hour 5200 again. Look at this insane sick entry on the 4 hour. Look at this insane sick entry on the 4 hour. So let's say you're short and then your stop was at the 200, okay? So you get stopped out here. And then you can decide whether or not to re-enter or place asks at the 200, which is another strategy to play the EMAs. So you can put your bids at the 200 here. Anyway, so if your asks are here or you're not in and you get back in, you're just holding until it either breaks the 50, which it did here, or breaks the 200 again. Pretty simple. 5200 cross, golden cross, 250 cross, death cross, bullish, bearish. It's pretty simple. So that's a 4 hour. Here's Dash, which again hit insane bubble-like levels that I didn't even realize. And looking at ETH BTC, it's hard for me to like do the math on that because Bitcoin's in four digits now. But the fact that this hit like 50 bucks or something is just insane. This was a zone I was following for a while, which is basically the 50% from top to bottom. And a break of that was definitely a very bullish sign. You can see how it was support, then it became resistance, and then it got tested three times here on the daily. So those were your entries if you're going to have one. if you weren't sure based on the cloud. The cloud had you in, here, basically end of January, or mid-February, based on the bullish cloud. Again, I'm saying everything's bullish. Wait for the Kijun bounce, which is this 0.35, I don't even, 0.31, whatever that is, which basically already happened. And this just looks like a flag trying to build to a breakout again. Whether or not it'll break the local high, that's tough. That's pretty, these wicks are nasty. Nasty wicks. When you see 4 or 5 daily wicks like this, that does not say to me that this is going to be continuation, but it's an altcoin, who knows? Going to single doesn't look much different. Again, your entry would have been a little earlier, somewhere mid-January for sure, right in here. Broke the yearly pivot. I don't ever talk about those on altcoins, but I'm going to start. And your first target would always be the next pivot, which it hit, and you can see resistance, resistance, support, and then something happened. I have no idea. I don't know anything about fundamentals for any of these, but it went, just went parabolic completely. And now it's gathering itself. And again, you can see we had the Kijun bounce 1, 2, 3 times now. But overall, this is just a flag waiting to decide on what's going to happen. I wouldn't trade entry signals based on the daily at the at this moment on Dash just because it's too slow. You sort of have to zoom in. So if we go to 4 hour Dash, this is doubled cloud. Again, your entry signals were great. It had you in way back here. And you're long this whole time because your close is either a TK cross or a break of a fractal level, which I don't have shown on here. So you would have been stopped out here likely, but you could have gotten back in at any point here. Never broke the cloud this whole time, which is a good sign. So we get back to here. You can see it's closing below the Kijun and not really bouncing. So this kind of says you might want to look at an even lower time frame, like the 2 hour or the 1 hour. But one thing you can do is also just go to single cloud. Single cloud, you can see how noisy it is as far as the entries and exits are concerned. So your entry's over here somewhere. Here's an exit. Here's a re-entry. Here's an exit. Here's a re-entry. Here's an exit. So it gets a little noisier up in here. Anytime flags are occurring, you're going to see noisiness in the single cloud especially. So right now it's telling me not to be in a trade. You can see we're below the yearly pivot here. It's definitely still bullish, but I'd wait for it to finish consolidating and make a TK recross above the cloud. And we'd probably see a test of the cloud support here. And you'll notice this is around the Winklevi ETF date. So who knows how that would react, but a no is probably likely. So if there's a no, alts will probably go up. I don't know. So that's a good time frame to watch Dash on the 4 hour anyway. 4 hour single cloud between the 10th and the 13th. Then here's the 5200 on the daily. Again, excellent, excellent entry based on the Golden Cross. You'd be long around end of January this whole time. And you can see how insanely overbought this is just based on the distance it is from the 200. Based on that, I'm expecting it to crash back down to this 50% of the previous, or even the previous all-time high, which is like 0.025 maybe. Or just the yearly pivot, R1. I don't expect it to keep going based on the overbought conditions on the EMAs. And again, here's the 4 hour EMAs, entries here. It's super overbought. It's bouncing on the 50. Not much more to say. Dash USD Tether, again, insanely bubble-like. $60 it hit, Jesus. Looking for the Kijun bounce. I would not trade this on the daily cloud. Look at all this range that could just destroy you in a trade. Even on singled, so much real estate here that it could destroy you. Here was the old cup and handle target of $21, which is nothing at this point. But you can see how from there it just took off. And again, your entry based on the cloud is somewhere in here, which would be February 20th, February 15th, something like that. And you're just holding, holding, holding. Certainly when it starts breaking the Kijun and closing below the Kijun, that's definitely a worrisome sign for me if I'm in a long, but it's consolidating, it's a triangle. It could do anything from here. I don't expect it to break $60 soon. So we go to the 4 hour single cloud. You can see again exit here just like Dash is telling you to exit, and look how clean these signals are. Long, close your long, close your long. Okay. Beautiful signals on the cloud. That's what you want to see. You want to see thin cloud all the way up. That's what you want to see. When it starts to get thick like this, that's when you see consolidation. EMAs again, beautiful, long hair, super overbought, insane bubble-like conditions. And then 4 hour long all the way back here, insane bubble-like conditions, possibly bouncing on the 50. Now we go to Ripple, and you know how I know Ripple isn't like the other coins? Because it looks like this. It looks like it's in historic lows. This is the weekly, just selling off, no hope in sight. Ripple's trash, guys. I'm sorry. It should not be listed on CoinMarketCap. Okay. Monero daily. This was an old pitchfork, and it's interesting for a few reasons. One, it just busted completely out of the pitchfork, showing you definite bubble territory here, with a pullback to the median line of the pitchfork. Interesting, isn't that interesting? Going to daily, doubled. You can see the signals are super mixed as far as an entry is concerned. This doesn't say short or long. It's just kind of meh. I really wouldn't trade Monero based on all these charts. Stick to other coins. Definitely a better chance. If anything, wait for this to break the yearly pivot above the cloud, and then look for previous local high. Keep it simple like that. Singled doesn't really say much. It says to reshort here if you can short Monero anywhere. I don't think you can. Doubled 4 hours trying to break out of the cloud. Again, that could be an entry, but I don't really trust it. Singled's already out of the cloud. Possible entry, but it's broke out of the cloud on the 4 hour single twice before and hasn't gone anywhere. So I wouldn't trust this on the 4 hour. Monero 5200 cross on the daily. The cross was fine. As far as how you played it was up to you, but you can see how it's kind of basically consolidating around the 200 again. I'd either wait for the cross recross of the EMAs, or sometimes the EMAs just get flat and they touch and price is right there, and then it makes a decision. Kind of like here. I would stay out of Monero. Just look at the daily doubled cloud, or look at the daily 5200 for entry signals, which would likely be bullish entry signals, and then targets being the previous local highs. And the 4 hour 5200 just super noisy. Not worth watching, in my opinion. Litecoin, similar to XRP. I know how Litecoin is not like the other coins. It looks like this, pushing historic lows, just selling off week after week. This is the weekly Litecoin. Give me a break, Litecoin people. And again, here's the cloud, super depressing, just nothing but death. Below the cloud for days and days on end. Just no, just stay out of Litecoin until there's some sign of life. Doubled 4 hour again, just looks like trash. No hope. Hasn't broken the cloud since before February on the 4 hour, so I wouldn't touch it. Here's the 5200 on the daily. Look how great these crosses have been. Again, depending on how you play this, you can get in and out. You can get back in here if you're short on futures anyway, and just stay out of Litecoin. Here's the weekly cloud. LTC USD, because somebody inevitably asks me, "You didn't chart LTC USD, you charted LTC BTC." Well, here you go. These are the targets. It's below the cloud. It's got weeks, if not a year, before any hope of possibility of anything, so I would stay out of it. If you're in it, like my friend IRL, sorry for him, definitely. ETC BTC doesn't have a lot of data, so you have to go down to lower time frames, especially if you're using the doubled cloud. This is the 2 hour cloud, and you can see the signals, price above cloud, bullish TK, bullish cloud, lagging span in price above cloud. So overall, it's very bullish. It looks like it's consolidating in a nice triangle here. I'd expect it to hit this zone should it continue, which is previous resistance, support turned resistance, and kind of like the 50% of that area. 4 hour 5200 have been kind of noisy just because it's been so spiky, but again, a great entry would be golden cross of the 5200 on the 4 hour. NEM, XEM, I don't even know how to say that, but all the signals on doubled look good for long. It's kind of weird because it's below the yearly pivot, so that would be the first target now. Going long here is fine. I think. I don't think it's too overbought. I think it's just getting started as far as targets are concerned. I like the 50%, 0.15, whatever, not 0.15, 1539 and the R1. Not much else to say about that. Golden Cross is happening right now. You heard it here first, folks. The Golden Cross for NEM on the daily chart currently happening. That's a long entry signal. So go long, baby, and hold it. Hold it for the pivot and the R1. That's what I'd do. I might do that, in fact. Made safe coin looks just sadness. Below the yearly pivot, below the cloud, below Tenkan even. Just sad, sad, sad. Targets are painted for as resistance up here, but I'd stay out of it. Nothing looks great there. And again, 5200. If you're ever not sure about the cloud, just go to the 5200. Entry was here. Again, depending on how you play this, exits could be breaks of the 50, exits could be, your hard exit could be break of the 200, whatever you want to do. So, Golden Cross, Death Cross, wait for the Golden Cross again to reoccur for the entry. Rep, Auger, just a bunch of mixed sideways garbage nonsense. I'd stay out of this until signals get better. Just, yeah, this is definitely the target. Basically, the ICO sell-off point. But doesn't look great. Could be a possible inverted head and shoulders here, but it's pretty dirty, nasty looking if it is. Zeke on the 4 hour singled. Again, if there's not much data, you kind of have to curve fit a little bit to figure out what goes where. Signals are mixed, but bullish, which is what you want to see pre-entry. So if you want to watch this on the 4 hour, watch for the TK cross to recross here, as far as your entry is concerned. Or just wait for the previous local to break and confirm as support. And on the 4 hour, I wouldn't touch Zeek. This is so Zeek doesn't have that much data, but I wouldn't touch it until you get the cross of the 5200, which is close considering where it came from. But if you look at the weekly chart, it just looks like an L. For loser, that's all I got for today, guys. Like, dislike, hit me up on Twitter and Telegram, and happy trading.